Has the Jeep Gladiator been discontinued? Did they throw in the towel? Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to Rob Motive JT. It is a sunny, blue sky day here in the RGV in South Texas. And the big question is, has the Jeep Gladiator been discontinued? Did Jeep, Fiat, Chrysler throw in the towel? You know, I recently went out and I thought I'd take a look at my local Jeep dealer's website to see how many Gladiators they had available. Now, I was shocked. I went out and there were none available. So I decided to expand my scope a little bit, check out another dealership and see if I could find any. What I found was a little bit shocking, actually. First of all, the dealership in total has 115 vehicles, which is quite a lot for right now. As far as Jeep Gladiators or any Jeeps go, the breakdown was 2 Jeep Compasses, 20 Grand Cherokee Ls, 19 regular Grand Cherokees, no Jeep Wranglers, none. And 5 Jeep Gladiators. But there's a little asterisk beside that. They're in transit. Now, given the current shortage of all of the vehicles out there, that doesn't make me feel too confident if I'm looking for a Jeep Gladiator. I mean, there are some coming sometime. So, what are they? What are the trim levels of these 5 Jeep Gladiators that they have, but they don't have? First of all, number one, they have a high altitude. It is $55,095 and in a striking white. Number two is another high altitude. It is $55,340 and it is the gorgeous Schnazberry. Number three is the Jeep Mojave. Surprising that they have a Jeep Mojave coming, because you would think that would be even more scarce, but I guess it's a bigger moneymaker for Jeep, so it might actually make a little bit of sense. That vehicle is $55,745, again, in white. Number four, another Jeep Mojave. Again, I'm really surprised that they've got Mojaves coming. You know, when they first came out, they were relatively scarce. But they have another one coming. It's $55,990, and it is in the gray. I believe the Sting gray, which is an awesome color. I really do like that one. And number five is a Jeep Gladiator Rubicon, $65,210. You know, the prices are just amazing to me. That one is also in white. So I guess they do have a couple of different colors. You know, the gray, the Snazberry, but predominantly, I mean, 3 out of 5 are white. Now, interestingly, it did not say anything on the website about any sort of a market adjustment or premium that's being added to the cost of these Jeeps. However, given my experience from what I've seen at a couple of other dealers on some other brands, I wouldn't be surprised if indeed there is some sort of market adjustment that will be applied once they actually arrive at the dealership. Now, my plan is once they actually show some stock, to head over there and take a look and see if they are adding to the price. You know, recently I was out shopping around for trucks and I was looking at the Chevy Silverado. And I got in it, I took the test drive, and it's funny, there was nothing noted on the sticker about this. But I'm in it, I'm doing the test drive, and the sales guy tells me that right now, and this was just a few days ago, they are adding a premium to every sticker of $8,000 to $10,000. Now, this was stickered, I believe, at $51,000. And it was just a Chevy Silverado RST was the trim line. Nothing really special about it. I mean, it didn't knock your socks off when you got inside, but $10,000 more would put that truck at $61,000. Plus tax, tag, title, all that stuff. You're looking at
somewhere probably in the $64,000-$65,000 range for a regular, what I'll call a regular, Chevy Silverado. I was shocked. And it was interesting to me that I wasn't told there was a premium being added to it until I was already in the truck. Now, obviously, the reason for that is they want you to get in the truck, fall in love with it, because the philosophy is two things. The longer you spend at the dealership, the more likely you are to actually buy a vehicle. That's why they keep you there so long. And secondly, while you're out driving around in it, inhaling that intoxicating new car smell, that you'll fall in love with it and be willing to pay that extra money because you just have to have it. I decided, of course, as soon as I heard that while I was riding around, there's no way I was going to pay a premium. Now, I will tell you, full disclosure, in all honesty, I have paid a premium one time on a vehicle, and I regret it ever since the day I did it, and that was on the Honda Civic Type R. They had first came out, and I really wanted one, right? So I found one, and I wanted a particular color. It was that stunning blue that they had. So I found one. It was about 2 hours away from me. Talked to the dealer, and of course they had a market adjustment because it was brand new. You couldn't find any. They were in short supply. So I drove the 2 hours, and I paid the $5,000 market adjustment to get that car. Now, did I recoup it when I sold it? Of course not. Nobody's going to pay me that extra $5,000. And then, you know, they became more prevalent. There were more out there. So the market adjustment eventually went away. They took it off. So I lost that money. What a stupid thing I did. And I will never do that again. That's why when I was driving that Silverado and I was told there was a $8,000 to $10,000 markup, that sealed the deal for me. Then it just became a pleasure ride and a pleasant conversation with the sales guy. But it's just insane, absurd. Now, let me give you another example. I was looking at another brand, and there was no markup on this brand. It was listed at MSRP. I asked them about it before I went very far into the process, about whether or not they were charging markups. They told me, no, they weren't. They were charging MSRP. And then there was also a rebate, a discount. Now, I will tell you that I would not pay MSRP either. We'll let that one sit right there. But if you're interested in what happened, make sure you check out my other channel. It is Rob Motive FST. There'll be more detail coming up on what that was all about over there. So check it out. So anyway, I just wanted to get on, kind of take a look myself, because a couple months ago, I had gone to the Jeep dealership when all this shortage stuff started, and they had a decent supply. They probably had 20 Gladiators on the lot. Not anymore. You can't find one on the lot. Not at least two of the dealers that I looked at in my area. They do have, I think, 5 used Jeep Gladiators sitting there. Anyway, leave a comment. Let me know if you're in the market, you're looking for a Gladiator. Have you physically been able to find any on the lots? And are they charging a market adjustment, a markup? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I do have 2 additional channels. Rob Motive, all about my 2020 Toyota Tacoma. And Rob Motive FST about my hunt for the upcoming redesigned Toyota Tundra and maybe something else. Check them out, and if you're interested, why not subscribe? Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.